Ahoy, hoy, everybody. It's the Lazy Eyed Mauler in the Woody Workshop. That is not the droid you are looking for. Move along. Okay, this time around I want to do some shout-outs and some show information. As far as project updates, I'd said I'd do. The garbage truck is still in a box over here, but I do have, I don't know if we're going to see this, but we have the 29 Ford in this bucket. All the parts have been washed, and you have to take my word for it. All the parts have been washed. I just have to mount them and get them ready for painting. That was a week ago, and then it started snowing here. And although we don't have a ton of accumulation, it's like every morning before going to work and then coming back after work having to clean. And I just haven't been in the mood, so hopefully that will quit soon and I'll get back to this. I have my color combination ready to go for that, so that would be good. And that's about as far as I have for updates, project updates. First thing I want to do is a shout out to a YouTube community member. This past weekend, I got the latest issue of Scale Auto, February 16. So that's what it looks like. It has the 29 Ford and the 36 Lowboy on there, as well as a really cool Firebird Pro Mod. But the shout out I want to do is to Pat Redmond. There's coverage from Toledo NNL, and he has this little Model A Phaeton, or is it a 32? No, it's a 29 Model A Phaeton. He had it at NNL Toledo, and it's a really sweet little model. It got picked to be covered in Scale Auto. So kudos, Pat. Good for you. There is a lot of models there, so to be picked for Scale Auto, that's pretty cool. I just want to mention the top 10 list. Congratulations to the 7 people in the top 10 list, especially Mr. Mini Dreams for being in the top spot, but congratulations to everybody that's decided to participate in that and submitted models for that, and it's underway, so it's pretty cool, and I know there are people getting ready to join in February and the month after, and should be interesting to see how that goes. So kudos to Chip and his judges, and it should be interesting. Just have fun with it, and it should be a really cool part of the community. I also wanted to mention Little Joe's Street Outlaws build. That looks like it should be some fun, and I look forward to the eye candy that's going to come out of that, and there should be some cool stuff. Even just judging by the entry videos, there should be some cool stuff coming out of that, and that'll be fun to watch. Thirdly, Old Beater Cars, I'm sorry that the junior stock build did not take off. Maybe we can try that again later, because I wouldn't mind doing a junior stock build, but I'm just not there yet, so maybe in the fall. We'll have to see. I'm sorry it didn't work out, and I hope you're not too discouraged and that you, you consider trying it again, maybe at a later date. I'm trying to do things quick here so this doesn't go on too long, so I'm going to move on to some events coming up. Now, most of this is going to be for the guys in Ontario, Canada, or at least those within southern Ontario. But if you're anywhere close in New York or, Michigan or whatever, you might want to attend some of these. I don't know. But the first few things I'll mention is just to update guys here in Ontario. First, Car Guys. Brandt's Hatch is coming up. That's in Toronto. It's put on by Groups 25 and Brandt's Hatch. It's a slot car and model car show, and a hobby flea market. It's a really good flea market. I think I've been to each one since they've started this. Lots of stuff to buy. I know originally the idea was it was supposed to be like an NNL type of thing. It wasn't, I mean, no offense to them, I don't think it was really clear that's what it was supposed to be, so that aspect didn't seem to take off. I don't know if they're still trying to do it that way, but so I don't know what to say. You can go to www.group25.org to get more information. Might be the trip if you're looking to do some shopping and whatnot. Might be worth a trip to Toronto. It's kind of just on the edge between Toronto and Mississauga on Horner off Brown's Line. So that's one for the car guys. One for everybody. The next one up is Heritage Con 10. Heritage Con has been going for 10 years now, so that's the 10. That happens in Hamilton, Ontario on Sunday, March the 20th, 2016, at 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Canadian Warplane Heritage Museum. That is such a cool location for a show. I think I've posted pictures from it in the past. I don't remember, but I mean, where else can you go and check out an Avro Lancaster while you're at a model contest? I mean, really, it's just fantastic planes there. It's a big show, lots of vendors, lots of models on the tables. It's really worth your while if you want to come check that out. So, if you want to check it on the web, it's www.heritagecon.ca. So, that's coming up March 20th. And backing up for a minute, the Brands Hatch Slot Car Model Car Show is Sunday, March 6, 2016. And coming up in May is a show that kind of comes and goes in the Toronto area. It's called Torcan 2016. It's being put on by the Peel Scale Modelers. It's at Century Gardens Recreation Center in Brampton, Ontario. From what I understand, most of their vendor tables have pretty much sold out, and they have 63 of them, so that should give you a lot of vendors. Different theme awards. So if you want to check it out, you can go to www.torcanmodelshow.com, or if you're on Facebook, it's facebook.com/torcanmodelshow. And yeah, this is just a preliminary flyer, so there's no categories or anything on here. I can just tell you the automotive category for that one is pile in, and that is station wagons, vans, and buses. So that should be interesting. And the other show thing I wanted to mention is NNL East. If you don't have your room yet, make sure you check out nnleast.com. Try to get into the host hotel. And the main reason I'm bringing it up is I just want to review the three themes that they have this year. And the first theme is Cars of the 30s. Since it's the 30th anniversary of NNL East, it should be a really good show. But they went with Cars of the 30s. And they also went with the decal set that they gave out. And there's going to be a slight pause here. Okay, and we're back. The second theme for NNL East is the NNL East decal sheet that was given out at NNL East 29. The idea is you build a model and you use these decals, and it helps celebrate the 30th anniversary of NNL East. Now, if you didn't go to NNL East 29 and receive these decals, you can go to nnleast.com, and then you can send them an email. I'm pretty sure through the site. I believe it's modelcitizen@aol.com. Yeah, I should have looked that up ahead of time, but I'm going to stick you guys with it. If you're really interested, go to nnleast.com. I'm sure there's a email contact there. Pardon me. That's Tom Geiger. He's the president of the club that puts it on. He's been on Model Cars Forum, as well as Spotlight Hobbies, and he's offered, if you want a set of those decals, to let him know and he'll mail them out to you. So I suggest if that sounds like a fun project to you and there's a chance you might go to NNL East in April, it might be worth your while to right away and start that project. And finally, on January 1st, they always announce a internet theme for the show, and this year the internet theme is the Mobius Ford pickups. So if you've done a Mobius Ford pickup or you want to do one and you're coming to NNL East, you're all set to go. That'll be one of the themes. I mean, it's always a case of, bring whatever you've built during the year and that type of thing, but those are the three themes, and if you want to build something for the themes, that's what you're looking at. So by now, this video is probably about 10 minutes long or more, so I better quit while I'm ahead or I'll never upload. I hope everybody's doing all right in this new year so far. It's been a rough year on celebrities so far. They're dropping like flies, but otherwise, I hope everybody is healthy and well. And we're doing good here, except for snow. And I'd rather have snow than wildfires, earthquakes, and all the stuff that some of you poor folks put up with. Anywho, enough rambling. Everybody take care, keep building, keep sharing here on YouTube, and we'll see you the next time. Bye now.